Salvador Allende was born on July 26, 1908, in Valparaiso, Chile. He attended the University of Chile, where he was a med student and became a physician. In medical school, Professor Max Westenhofer influenced Allende, who stressed on social medicine. While he was in college, he got involved in radical politics. He was the founder of the Socialist Party in 1933. He had close ties to the Communist Party and eventually became the Democratic President of Chile in 1970 at the age of 62.
As the president, Allende created a socialist government in Chile in order to improve the country's economy. When he became president, Chile was in a rough economic state. There was a 30% inflation rate and 20% unemployment. He wanted to redistribute the wealth and land equally between all citizens. Allende was able to increase wages by 40% while not allowing companies to raise prices on their products. He nationalized the copper industry and the banks to provide more jobs. Because he was able to create such a centralized national government, Allende was also able to dedicate a lot of social spending money on public housing, education, and healthcare. Even before his presidency, he had created the first form of public healthcare in the Americas. The fact that Allende was such a powerful socialist put President Nixon on edge in the United States. In September 1970, in an attempt to discourage Allende, Nixon dedicated $10 million to the CIA and authorized them to take action.
Due to the fact of Allende's ideal perspective of socialism and his connection to the Communist Party, the American president, Richard Nixon, opposed him. Written in a CIA document ordered by Nixon, it is stated that it is a firm continuing policy that Allende be overthrown by a coup. In June of 1973, Allende appointed his commander-in-chief, Augusto Pinochet, of the Chilean army. Little did he know, Pinochet was working with the CIA to overthrow Allende's power. On September 11, 1973, President Nixon's plans to overthrow the Chile government had succeeded when Pinochet led the U.S. military in to overthrow the presidential palace in Santiago, Chile. Before the death of President Allende, he recorded his speech addressing the citizens of Chile as his final words to his people.
Workers of my country, I have faith in Chile and its destiny. Other men will overcome this dark and bitter moment when treason seeks to prevail. Go forward knowing that sooner rather than later, the great avenues will open again where free men will walk to build a better society. Long live Chile, long live the people, and long live the workers. These are my last words, and I am certain that my sacrifice will not be in vain. I am certain that, at the very least, it will be a moral lesson that will punish felony, cowardice, and treason.
Until May of 2011, it was believed that Allende had died due to the bombing of his presidential palace, except for the few who believed that he had shot himself. Many of his supporters had refused to believe this. In order for this to be proved or disproved, an autopsy was performed. It was then revealed that he had shot himself. There are claims that the CIA helped to train several members of Al-Qaeda and funded Osama bin Laden against the Soviet Union. Robin Cook, the UK Foreign Secretary from 1997 to 2001, made these allegations against the United States, saying that bin Laden was funded throughout the 80s by the CIA and funded by the Saudis to wage jihad against the Russian occupation of Afghanistan. Evidence has been found to disprove this accusation, however. In fact, bin Laden states that, personally, neither I nor my brothers saw any evidence of American help. We were never, at any time, friends of the Americans. We knew that the Americans supported the Jews in Palestine and that they are our enemies. 28 years after Allende's death, the United States was attacked by Al-Qaeda on September 11, 2001. Although these dates have no significant relationship, the sheer irony that our country was attacked on the same day that we invaded another country politically is enough to cause superstition. Both events caused social turmoil in the country that was affected.